So Iceland's finally here. We've been pretty excited about this one. We're on Westman Islands, which is a group of islands off the south coast of Iceland. It's got the world's largest puffin colony and was pretty much destroyed by a volcanic eruption in the 1970s. So we're doing the puffin volcano tour. We're about to start that now, so that's what you do here. So hopefully see some puffins. There's a big statue of a puffin over there. Puffin. So that's what we're in for. Geordie made a friend. What's his name?
Porg.
Porg. Nailed it. This was the Puffin Mountain. Probably can't see it, but there's swarms of puffins just flapping away above. They can't really fly very well.
Look at their little nests.
They're real tries. So, Geordie.
Yeah.
What did we just do? And what are you doing?
Being a puffin.
You've been a puffin. So Westman Islands, apparently one of the windiest places in Europe, and we caught it on a pretty decent day. Got Geordie over there, looking cool.
There's a lava bomb.
Yeah.
And the volcano erupts, it gets thrown at you, and then when it lands, it explodes and there's fire.
Why didn't this one explode?
Because, I don't actually know. Decided to hang out.
Fail.
They don't get that colourful, don't worry, he won't bite. They don't get that colourful beak until the age of 5. And she's just almost 4 years old. So.
The world's most photographic puffin.
So this is Havdis, which means goddess of the sea.
I've got to have this.
She's got to have this. Have this is gonna go to sleep now. Good night.
Have this.
See ya, buddy. Whoa. Hello. This is a new puffin baby.
Awesome.
Oh, wait. Whoa. That hello. Came in last night. Flew down from the mountains.
Hi.
They're gonna release it tonight. So this is one of the famous Icelandic native horses. They're quite small. They're smaller than regular horses, but they're pretty. And they've got really fur. Nay. Hi, Mac Litter. That is this thing right here. It's a big mountain, 283 meters with cliff faces and ladders and good fun things. And Geordie the champ is gonna climb it.
Ah!
How you feeling, Smudge?
Fabulous.
Fab? Ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's do it. So this is where we thought the top was from the bottom. But it turns out the mountain keeps going. All right, to give you a bit of a summary of what to do on Westman Island, first of all, climb the mountain. It's cooler than it looks from the bottom, and you can pretty much get a good view of the whole island, the main habitated island in the group. So basically right over in the distance there is the rock at the back where we went and saw the puffins. So that's connected by a bridge that was created by a volcano pretty recently. And then those two mountains there, the one that's half brown, that was a volcano that erupted for 4 years back in the 1960s, and it's got the cove that has the music festival every August just behind that. And that mountain that's completely brown and red now is the mountain that was created from the volcanic explosion in the 1970s. So that whole area there was at sea level about 40 years ago, 40, 50 years ago. So down there is the town, and you've got lucky house number 13 down there as well, which is the last house that survived when the volcano erupted. So house number 11 wasn't so lucky, so that's actually underground at the moment, but lucky number 13 is still there. And down there we've got everything else really. So we've got the Puffin Museum where we saw the baby puffins. So about this time, so actually yesterday they started doing it, is the baby puffins jump out of their nest and fly down to the only light they can see, which is the town. So then all of the Icelandic kids, they run around with flashlights after dark trying to find these baby puffins, and then they go and set them loose in the sea because that's where they're actually trying to get to. And we actually walked past this lady who had a baby puffin that she let me hold. Pretty cool that she found last night, and they're going to go set it free in the ocean tonight. So it's pretty cool. There's the harbour down there. Got the wife down here. The guest book is up there. We're going to go sign that. But at the top of the mountain now, and the view is amazing. Hey, Jody.
Hi.
How'd you go?
Good.
Did you go up the mountain?
Yeah, I'm at the top. I did it.
Yep.
It was scary.
How do you feel?
Good.
You feel good?
Proud of myself.
I'm proud of you too.
Thank you.
I think everybody's proud of you. Look at you.
Minimal tears.
No, there was a few tears.
But though minimal.
Woo! Puffin! So we're day two in Iceland. Going down the south coast. First stop, Seljalandsfoss. I'm sure I'm saying that wrong. The waterfall. Pretty cool. We're going to walk up the back there and go behind the waterfall. We're behind the waterfall now. It's actually pretty cool. You can just gaze out at Iceland from inside a little waterfall cave. Skogulfoss. Something to that effect. We're going to climb up there. Check out the rainbow and the waterfall. So we're at Dyrhólaey. It's the big rock arch that everyone always talks about, and you've seen all the photos. We'll go on the other side. We've got the black beach too. So go in there, have a play, but just chilling. We're breaking the rules, so we are behind the metal fence. So if we die, then it's just, that's on us. So I've lost the wife, but I finally found the arch. So we found the trolls from Frozen. They're down the south coast of Iceland, and for miles and miles they've got these volcanic boulders covered in the green moss, which is where they got the idea for the trolls off Frozen. So if anyone's got a frozen heart, we've got you covered. Little pit stop on the way to the glaciers to check out the scenery. Whole bunch of sheep, and they don't want a bar of Jordy. Tried to feed him some bread, they ran away.
Yeah.
So we've arrived at Jökulsárlón, the glaciers and the icebergs, and there's about 15 seals just chilling out in this little area here.
Trying to whistle them over.
See, Jordy's trying to be the seal whisperer. This guy's pretty cute. He's keen. And there's a whole heap of them over there. See, we didn't even know they'd be around here. Go on, Jody. What do you got?
A glacier.
Jody's deadlifting the glacier.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
iceberg is about to crash into all the seals. Bang. Day 3 in Iceland. We're saying goodbye to Christian at Holsvola at our Airbnb here. So, pretty cool place. There's Jordy in the Beast. That's 12 horsepower, pure muscle right there.
Oh, hi, didn't see you there. Welcome to Kira. It's a crater that is 6,500 years old, and it is in Iceland, and the water is about 14 meters deep, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
So we're inside a volcanic crater at Kira in Iceland. Jody's having fun. I think off next to Geyser.
Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
So, I'm in Geyser with this geyser, the second stop on the Golden Circle Tour. This goes off about every 10 to 15 minutes. We had a few times last time. Tribal brewing. Give us your slow motion Geyser dance, Jordy. So, just about waterfall number 265 in Iceland. It's number 3 stop on the Gold Circle to us, Gullfoss Waterfalls, and it's by far the best one. Very cool. So, this is the top part of it here. Much bigger part down the bottom. So we're at Thingvellir National Park. Last stop in the Golden Circle Tour. It's the heart of Iceland. Pretty cool, just sitting at the top, enjoying the view. Gonna walk down into the cracks in these rocks. Pretty cool. Not there, obviously. Hey, buddy. Hey. How you doing? Hey, Jordy. Hello. These are pretty good looking horses. I'm gonna give it to Justin Bieber over there. Justin Bieber of horses.
I feel like you didn't like that I moved your hair.
Ah, you ruined it. Hey, buddy.
We're back.
So our whale watching tour was cancelled due to poor weather. So we're just exploring northwest Iceland. There's Jordy down there playing on the beach. Got CJW, that's Charlie, Jordy and Whippy. Little laugh out down there. Say hi, Jordy. So we found another waterfall in northwest Iceland. It's in a town called Ola, and that's it there. And down there is where our whale watching tour would have started, but the weather's a bit poor, so they've called that off. Jordy's waiting down there in the car.
With me, puffins we will be.
It's our last full day in Iceland. The whale watching tour got cancelled because of the poor weather, so we decided to go down to Reykjavik early and spend the day here. So we're walking around Old Town now. It's actually pretty cool. It's a small city. It's about 200,000 people,
So it's, we're about to go down to the waterfront, see the Opera House, learn about some Viking stuff, but...
Yeah, just gonna kick back. We finally got the weather we were promised. It's really cold and rainy, so we're gonna just enjoy our last day in Iceland. Yawn.
That's amazing.
So we've nicknamed this guy Whippy because he loves a pat, and every time we stop patting him, he headbutts us.
A little nuzzle. See, look, hello. Come back for more.
That guy's a bit feisty. Must go outside. Hey, buddy.
So is this itching or is it like grooming or what?
It's kind of both. So okay. In the wintertime they get really fluffy. And some take more time to get rid of the fluffiness than the others. Only those who are friends do it to each other.
Oh,
I'm this guy's loving a scratch.
Yeah.
There you go. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
Oh, it's nice.
We're wrapping up our trip in Iceland here with our special guest. We just came and did a meet and greet with the Icelandic horses, learned about the breed, and had a little ride around this paddock here. But yeah, all in all, really enjoyed the trip. We started off with the Westman Islands, saw the puffins, and climbed a mountain. Then we drove around the south coast and went down to Jökulsárlón, glaciers, the icebergs. And then we drove around the Golden Circle, did the geyser, the big waterfalls in the national park. And unfortunately, the whale watching was cancelled due to poor weather, but that gave us a bit more time in Reykjavik, which is a really cool little town. And this morning just came and did the little horse tour, and now we're jumping on the plane and going back to London. But all in all, had a great time, and looking forward to Wales next month.